Hey, so what happened? How come you never did any more movies?
Well, I tried to make a career out there in Hollywood, but I just didn't realize how tough acting is.
Well, you know what they say, tough acting ten acting.
I wish I'd known that then. You see, life after Halloween 4 wasn't exactly smooth sailing. Once I stepped out from behind that mask, Hollywood gave me the cold shoulder. The work I did manage to get was usually just bit parts that didn't last too long. Like the role of Denise's boyfriend on The Cosby Show.
It's nice to meet you, Martin.
Thank you, Mrs. Huxtable. So, if you guys are a family, why are none of you the same shade of black? I was also coked out of my skull most of the time. But whatever the case, I was done. I left Hollywood, moved back to my hometown of Quahog, and wound up working here as a news anchor.
Wow. Well, don't you miss it?
Every second of every day, but I can't touch coke again. It would ruin my life.
No, I mean acting.
Oh, of course, but it's over for me. That's all in the past.
Well, if you ask me, you got the makings of a star, and I want to help you get there.
Well, that's a nice offer, but I'm not quite sure how you expect to do that.
Well, you've brought me so much joy over the years as that lovable murderer of teenagers, and I want to return the favor.
I don't even have an agent anymore.
Well, and how about this? I'll be your agent.
You?
Yeah, I've seen every episode of Entourage. All you need is some fake hair and a bunch of hobbits hanging around you.
You're on in 5 minutes, Mr. Tucker.
You don't belong here. You're better than this. You're Halloween 4 better.
Look, I appreciate your offer, but I've got a pretty good thing going here. In a few minutes, I've got to be on camera in front of 800 people. Good evening, Quahog. I'm Tom Tucker. Our top story tonight, the Rhode Island Historical Society is heralding the arrival of a cast-iron, oak-handled colonial bedsheet warmer, now on display in the Statehouse Rotunda. Okay, there it is. As I understand it, they would put the coal inside of that and then put the object between the sheets. It was very cold back then, and it would warm the sheets. And I think that's the gist of it. How much footage of this do we have? Oh, this is live. Can she hear me? Okay, you can put it down now. She can't hear me. Okay. What the hell is going on here? Am I having a stroke?
Wait, Peter, don't go!
So, you changed your mind, huh, buddy? We going to Hollywood?
You betcha. But I have to say, I thought you'd drive a fancier car.
What? Why?
Well, aren't you the Peter Griffin of Peter Griffin Cadillac?
No, that's another guy.
Hi, I'm Peter Griffin. And at Peter Griffin Cadillac, we believe in three things. Fair dealing, family, and friendship. I've lived in Quahog my whole life. I love it here. And you're gonna love a Peter Griffin Cadillac.
Scumbag.